Hello children, so in the last class we learned what is a decimal number. Okay, so you got the definition of a decimal number, no children? So what is a decimal number? Yes, decimal number is a category, a group of fraction in which the denominators will be the multiples of tens. Okay children, and the numerator part we will express as the decimal place. Clear? And we also learned how to read a decimal number. So how it was? Yes, after the decimal point you have to pick out each digit. Like if it is 134, you can't write it as 134. How to read that? 0.134, like that we have to read. And we also learned to convert a given fraction to the decimal number. So that how it was? Yes, first we need to count the number of zeros in the denominator, then as many digits we have to write in the decimal place. If the digits are not sufficient, what we did? Yes, we have to add zeros. Okay, then we have to write that numerator part. So this much is clear for you, right? Yes. Now today we will learn the place value of a decimal number. So before going to the decimal number, first you tell me what is the place value of a normal number. Yes, how it will, from the right side we have to start. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, lakh, 10 lakh, and so on. Okay, but the right side, I mean, so there will be a whole number part. I am giving you such an example. There is a whole number part, then decimal point, then the decimal places. So children, now see here, look into the board. See, this is the whole number part. This we have already learned. This 5 stands for ones, 4 stands for tens, 3 stands for hundreds, and 2 stands for thousands. This you already know, no? Now this is the decimal place. So after the decimal place, children, it's very important there is no ones place. Okay, because in the last class itself we learned, no? Like we have to start with 10. Like this we have to start with 10 and we are taking one portion, like 3 by 10. Okay, so it is starting from the 10th place, children. 10th, not tens. Okay, 10th, T-E-N-T-H-S. Write 10, then add T-H-S. Then comes 100th. So first you need to write 100, then add THS. Then if 1000, that means first write the spelling of 1000, then add THS. So like that, towards the right side, it starts from 10th, then comes 100, 1000, 10,000, lakhs, lakh, okay, TH, like that. You need to add. So understood, no children, how to write? So how to write this in expanded form? See children, if it is a normal number, how to write this in the expanded form? Ones, tens, hundreds, no? So we will write 3 × 100 plus 5 × 10 plus 6 × 1. This is the expanded form, right? This also you can write it as 300 plus 50 plus 6. This is also correct. But if it is in the case of a decimal number, how we will write? Yes, instead of this, it will come as a fraction. See, the same example we will do. Same example. Here, starts from 2000 plus 300 plus 40 plus 5. Then, now we started the decimal point. Okay, so the first number, how to write? 7. 7 is in which place? It is in 10th place. So it will come as 7 by 10. Okay. Instead of into, here it is a division. Now 9, how to write? 9 is in which place? 100th place. So 9 by 100. Then comes 6. 6 by 1000. Is it clear, children? Clear? Instead of writing in the this form, I mean in the multiplication form, we have to convert that number into the fraction form, because the decimal number means what? Yes, it is a fraction in which the denominators are multiples of 10, no? So the wherever there is a decimal number, In the expanded form, you need to write like this. You should convert that into the fraction form. Clear? Children, very clear, no? This you can also write as 7 into 1 by 10. But this it will be difficult. Okay. So, we will do 7 by 10. Clear? 7 by 10, 9 by 100. Then comes 6 by 1000. So, no need to write in this formula, children. This will be easy, I think, for you. Okay. Clear now? So, the place value chart is clear, no, children? Yes, that's it. Now, we will do the exercise of this. So, we will continue the exercise. Exercise 6A. 3 mains we finished in the last class. So, I am going to start the 4th main today. 4th main. Okay. What is the question? We write rupees 17 and 65 paise as 17.65. Correct? No. 17 rupees 65 paise. How to write? 17 will be the whole number part. 65 will be the decimal part. Okay. So here, how will you write the following in decimal hundreds? So I am going to do C and D now. Fourth main C and D. What is the question? Rupees 187 and 60 paise. And is there, no? That and is indicating the decimal point. Okay. So, 187 rupees. So, that is the whole number part. 100. You can write the rupees symbol also. Okay. 187. Now, and. That means the decimal point. Now, what is the paisa? Yes, it is. How much? 60. 60 means 60. Okay. Clear. Now the last one. Rupees 1914. 1914. And. So decimal point. 8 paise. 8. How to write 8 paise, children? Yes, it is 08. If you write 80, it will come 80, no? So, that is why 08. Okay. Yes. Now, fifth main, you can do it in the reader itself, children. Look into the question. The first arrow points to 0.1. Okay. See here. This is the scale. Okay. This is a ruler. So, this is 0. After that, the first point. So, what is the first point indicates? It is 0.1. So, this is 0.1. Okay. Now, they are asking which numbers do the other arrows point to. I will do till here. D, E, F, you need to do it as homework. So, A. Children, A. See here, this is 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5. The dark line is the middle, correct middle. That is 0.5. Now, this is 0.6. So, what is the next point? Yes, it is 0.7. Okay. Now, what is the B? B indicates, see children, it is the division between 1 and 2. So, starts from 1. 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4. So, B is 1.4. Now, see here, now that part over. Now, what is C indicates? C, the arrow mark is exactly to the 2, the number 2. So, it is 2. Simply you can write 2 or 2.0. Both are correct. Understood, no children? DEF you can do it as homework. Okay. Clear, no? Yes. Now, children, this I will not send in the worksheet. Okay. So, other than that I am indicating now itself. You need to do this as the homework. You need to draw this scale in your classwork and mark this DEF. Even if you want, you can mark all this and you can write this. Then DEF, you need to do it as homework. Okay. Now, sixth main also the same type. The magnifying glass shows the part of the ruler between 8.2 and 8.7. It is only, children, they have zoomed it. Okay. It is only 8.2 and 8.7. See here, this is 2, no? This 2 is 8.2 and this 7 is 8.7. Okay. Now, so, the first arrow points to 8.34. Now, 8.2 over 8.3. From 8.3 they started. Okay. Now, see here.
if you close, you have to look close. See, after 3 it is 4th point. So the first arrow is 8.34. okay, now we need to mark the rest of the points. So what is this A indicates? It is correctly on what? Yes, it is on 4. Okay, so children, it is not 8.4. It is already written, it is between 8.2 and 8.7. Correct, no? So, this is, which point it is? This is 8.4. It's not 4, it is between 8.2 and 8.7. So, don't write it as simple 4. It is 8.4. Okay, now, the next B is after 4. 8.41, 8.42, 8.43, 8.45. So, B is 8.45. Then comes C. C is 8.5. After that, which line? Second line. So, 8.51, 8.52. C is 8.52. Then comes, after C what? D. So, D is which point? D is 8.6. Okay. Then comes fourth point, that is 8.61, 8.62, 8.63, 8.64. So, E indicates 8.64. Clear no children? Understood? Now the next main. Next main is seventh main.